Foolishness, definitely. Amen. The opposite of wisdom is foolishness. As a bona fide child of God, you cannot afford to be a fool. Tell your neighbor, don't be a fool. Tell another neighbor and show you're not a fool. When you are a fool, it means you don't have knowledge of some certain things. Because there are lots and lots and lots of things that are provided for us in Scripture that when you observe them to do, you will live an effective and fulfilled lifestyle. Amen. That you are not living an effective and fulfilled lifestyle is because there are some things that you're ignorant of. Put your right hand on your head. Say, Father, deliver me from ignorance. Amen. And I want you to understand that that is why the devil is always attacking Christians with information. He will always ensure that you have a wrong information so that you will stop in your tracks or if you are on the right track. Am I communicating tonight? Immediately he comes and twats the information and you're able to take the twatted information, you stop in the right track and you begin to go in the wrong track. Remember when Jesus finished fasting for 40 days, the devil came up and started quoting scripture for Jesus. Is that not strange? If he can quote scripture for Jesus, is it you that he cannot quote scripture for? He will always try to turn it upside down because he knows that the entrance of his word giveth life. If you catch a revelation from the word of God and put it in practice, you will always have a testimony attached to that revelation. Am I communicating tonight? And that is why what the devil is using as his main weapon of attack in these days is denting of people's image. Especially when he knows that the Lord is indeed in that place using that person effectively. And usually tell people, it is very easy to know where the presence of God is. How many of you know that? Amen. Because the Bible says that wherever the presence of God is, that there is what? Liberty. Anywhere the presence of God is, testimonies is always attached. Amen. Not manipulated testimonies, but original from the throne of grace. That those testimonies that the Lord gives to people and retains it in their lives. Because you know what the Bible says? It says that the gift of God is maketh rich and it added no sorrow. So any testimony you have and it has a sorrow package attached to it, there is a problem somewhere. Check that testimony, where it is coming from. Am I communicating tonight? Amen. Praise the Lord. Am I the only one in the house? Are you sure? Am I making sense? Praise God. So most times, when the devil sees that yes, indeed, you are about to testify because you have connected to where Jesus is, do you know what the devil will do? The devil will package a story to begin to tell you about that place. And immediately you begin to listen to the story, you begin to go back. And when you begin to go back, he will not package, if you were before, besides the fire, he will not package a proper fire for you to enter. Amen. In recent times, I do not know how many testimonies we have recorded. We cannot, in recent times, like let's say in the past 1 month, in the past 1 week has been a rain of testimonies. Let me say something to you. Let us look at scriptures. Let us look at scriptures. Put your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter number 11. Let's see what happened. Can you remember that song that we all used to sing? Everywhere he went, he was doing good. Almighty healer. He healed the leper. When the people saw him, they started walking. Everywhere he went, my Lord was doing good. It means that whenever you have an encounter with Jesus Christ, you have a testimony, right? And from that song, and from the account in scriptures, let us see what happened in Matthew 11 verse 19. Let me hear someone read. Can someone raise his or her voice and read it out? Let's hear. Matthew 11.
Son of man came eating and drinking.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, behold a man.
Who is gluttonous? Right?
A man who is gluttonous. And a wind beggar. And a friend of what?
Sinners.
And sinners. But wisdom is justified of her children.
God bless you. This is Jesus that they are talking about, though. He's a glutton. Wine babbler. Trying to say that Jesus eats too much. Maybe that he even begs for food if he is not able. That he's a friend to sinners. You are the Bible made us understand that Jesus actually came for sinners. If you don't go near them, how would they get saved? But do you know the problem? The devil had to tell the story. Because it's part of the mystery of the story that the people will stay away. And the devil had this story so strong in one of the cities called Nazareth. Am I making sense? The story was so strong in one of the cities called Nazareth. Why? That was Jesus' home place. Am I making sense? So they would look at him, they would say, who is this one? What is he talking about? Is this not the carpenter? Which day Jesus begin to miracle? No, it's not the way we know to see for this world. Mommy, you know the name of Anna? Now Mary's son. Joseph, now that chief carpenter of a village. Now that parent is his son, now he has son, man. You know why? Because the devil didn't want the people of Nazareth to benefit from the anointing of Jesus Christ. And he succeeded. Because Jesus couldn't perform even one miracle in that place. I am telling you this because you have to stay focused on your path until you grab your own miracle. As for getting it, you will get it. Because Jesus is the same today and forever. And I saw it in scripture that he's no respecter of persons. That the same God over all is rich unto all that call upon him. So if he can answer one person here, he can answer three people here. All you need to do is to catch the revelation of the word of what we teach and operate it in your favor, and you will see it working like wildfire. Am I communicating? Praise the Lord. Because if you read it there, the Bible says that wisdom is justified by her children. It means that there are some people that were foolish in that congregation, so they took it. Remember when Jesus went to a place and he cured demons and he sent the demons into the swine, and the swine went and drowned. Do you know what the people in the place said? Leave us. Children that had legion of demons inside him. One man had legion of demons. When you say legion, it means, you know, a group of them. He had it inside of him. And someone came and delivered him from that problem. In fact, that was one situation in scripture that the Bible made us to know that the man was walking naked. Meaning that he was totally mad. Mad to the feet. And the thank you his people will say to Jesus is leave us. Leave us now. Amen. I hope you know the scripture I'm talking about. Matthew 8. Matthew 8. Turn your Bible so that you read it for yourself. Matthew 8. Are you there now? Let's see. From 18 to 34. But we might not be able to read everything because of time. I want you to understand that people must talk. But you under should count for you. Amen. So far as the will of God is being done in your life, what people say about you should not bother you. You know why the Bible says in Psalm 34 that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but one thing is sure, the Lord delivereth him from them all. It means that the afflictions will come, but your deliverance is guaranteed. Hallelujah. Are you there now? Matthew 8. Amen. I just want to jump it. I want to jump it. I don't want to read everything. Amen. Let me just do from 28. When we have come to the other side, to the country. No. Let me still jump again. Let me jump again. Oh yeah, correct. From 28. When we have come to the other side, to the country of the Gerenes, then met him two demon-possessed men coming out of the tombs. You see, the demon possessed them so much so that they were sleeping in the grave. Coming out from the tombs, exceedingly fierce. Wow. So that no one could pass that way. Meaning that this demon possessed two guys, if they were to be in Ogudu, they would want Ogudu siege. Nobody would be coming across Ogudu. That's what the Bible is trying to say. And in 29, the Bible says, and suddenly they cried out, saying, what have we to do with you, Jesus, you Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the time? Now, a good way off from them, there was a herd of many swine feeding. Swine, that's the pigs feeding. So the demons begged him, saying, if you cast us out, permit us to go away into the herd of swine. And he said to them, go. Can someone say, I love the power of Jesus? Did you tell him just did it? Go. Tell your neighbor, authority. If you're a bona fide child of God, you also exercise your authority. Because he said, and I will give you power. That is what he said in Acts chapter number 1 and verse 8. In another scripture, he said, the same work I do, you will do. In fact, greater works you will do. Why? Because I have gone to meet with my Father. When you are fearful, something is wrong somewhere. Because God has not given you a spirit of fear, but that of boldness and a sound mind. As a Christian, when you come into situations you don't understand, begin to speak the heavenly language. When you speak scriptures, you talk about this realm. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. When you begin to speak scripture in a situation, you are no longer talking in this realm. You're talking in a higher realm. And when you're talking that way, you are commanding an authority that you yourself do not even know how mighty the authority is. Because the word of God is here and amen. He said, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will not pass away. And it must accomplish wheresoever I have sent it before it can come back to you. Amen. We are still in Matthew chapter number 8, right? And he said, go. So when they had come out, they went into the head of soil. And suddenly the whole head of soil ran violently down the steep place into the sea and perished in the water. Then those who kept them fled. After this time out, your enemies will flee before you. And they went away into the city and told everything, including what had happened to the demon possessed men. And behold, the whole city came out. Not just one man. The whole city came out to meet Jesus. And when they saw him, they begged him, they said, depart from our region. Leave us alone. Is that not the interpretation of that? Just go. Go with whatever power you are operating with. Go. We do not want. May you not be deceived in this instance. Let your yardstick be the word of God. Anything that you try by his word and you see a correlation with it and you pray over it and you have peace concerning it. Friends, let not the opinion of others debar you from catching your testimony in the word of God. Did you hear what I said? In faith challenge fellowship, we usually tell people, if you do not have a significant testimony in 6 months, something is wrong, so we stop coming. Why? Because we know the God we serve. We do not only read scriptures, we put it into practicals. You know, when you go to school, there's one called theory, there's another one called practicals. It is because most children of God do not have practicals. That's why they don't have results. Because it's only when you go to practicals, especially some of us that did biology, chemistry, and all those things. In the lab, there and there, when you need the thing, you will hear it, and it will change color. Is that also? They said it makes sense. You do it immediately, you see the results. Amen. The place of practicals in Christianity cannot be overemphasized. Hallelujah. Be on your feet. Are you there now? Close your eyes and I want you to tell God. Every walk of